The next person I'm going to introduce reminds me of something Bill Gaither said to me one time. Because when Bill Gaither discovers a new song or a new artist, he always shares them with everybody. And usually I've already heard of them. And he told me one time, he said, "You were here when the apostles were here." Well, the next man that we're having is Ben Speer. And he was here way before the apostles. And he came over to me and said, "I'm enjoying this so much. Thank you for asking me to come." So would you welcome Ben Speer to come out on stage with me? Come on, Ben Speer. A true legend. Did you know James D. Vaughan?
Yes, I did. Very well. We went to Lawrenceburg, Tennessee. I was born in North Alabama, and I moved to Lawrenceburg, Tennessee. It is Lawrenceburg.
Oh, good. Yes. I knew you'd get it right.
When I was a year old, and the family followed shortly thereafter. So this brings back so much history because, 1910.
Isn't that amazing?
Yes,
we couldn't have done
it
without you to tell us how it was then. Hasn't he done well? I appreciate you, Ben. I tell artists very often that if you want to be a good singer and be successful, buy all of Ben Speer's records. Because Ben knows how to sing and he knows how to pick good songs. Ben, tell us about what Lawrence Welk's someone told you one time.
Well, there was a jazz musician in Los Angeles that was a friend of the piano player for Lawrence Welk. And the jazz musician had heard about how fabulous Lawrence Welk's mansion was, and he always wanted to go through it and get a tour. So his friend said, "I'll take you." So he was leading him through the mansion, and he was just blown away with so much beautiful, such a magnificent living house. And so he bragged and bragged and bragged so much about it, and then this piano player for Lawrence Welk said, "Well, you see what happens when you play the melody?"
You singers will get that, but it's the truth. And Ben Speer has the Ben Speer School of Music. It's a continuation of the Stamp Spector School.
That's right.
And he's still teaching young people how to learn the tune and do the four parts. So Ben, you're a wonderful, wonderful person and have been a great model of gospel music. And I want to present this to you tonight on behalf of the Sgmg. Sgmg, that's it. I'm so excited. And we want to thank you and acknowledge your significant contributions to gospel music.
Thank you so much
to be here. Is anybody going to take our picture? Isn't that beautiful?
Oh, that's great. Wonderful.
And I'll let you take it home, but first, I'll let you have it after you sing us a song.
Okay.
And I have an all-time favorite. Would you do it?
What's that?
Gonna Rain?
Yeah, oh, okay.
All right. Or do you have another one you'd rather do? I'm not going to argue with a legend.
You know what Rex Neeland said a legend is.
Oh, I know what Rex Neeland says.
Legend means.
Tell me again.
You're old.
So thank you, and afterwards I'll give you this back, but sing for your award. Thank you, Ben.
Nice hand for Karen Apple.
Tell me, didn't it rain,
children? Rain all the time. Yes, you know it did. Stop still and listen to me. God walked down by the briny sea. He beheld the evil of a sinful man, declared that he would destroy the land. He spoke to Noah. Noah stopped and said, "Look here, Noah, build me an ark. Well, I want you to build it big and strong. Build it 300 cubits long, 30 high and 50 wide. I want it to stand by rain and tide.
Rain,
children. Rain all the time. Yes, you know it did. Oh, didn't it rain? When I after God told him what to do, Brother Noah began to cut and hew. The ring of the hammer was judgment. The ring of the saw cried, sinner, repent. For now 100 years, the hammer and sawed, building the ark by the grace of God. After the foundation was laid, he hewed the timber. The ark was made while he called in the animals two by two, the ox, the camel, and the kangaroo. Then he called in Japheth, Shem, and Ham. God began to flood the land. He raised up hands to the heavens on the high, knocked the sun and moon from the sky, shook the mountains, stirred the sea, pitched the winds to his chariot wheel. When he stood on land, stepped on board, he cried that time wouldn't be no more. Well, I know it rained, you know it rained, hard rain, cold rain, it rained all day, it rained all night, there was no land, no air in sight.
Rain
all the time. Yes, you know it did.